Welcome to class 3, subject social studies. Today's topic is our occupations. You may have seen people around you doing different jobs. There are jobs like teachers, doctors, shopkeepers, milkmen, and domestic helps who work to earn a living. They get paid for the work that they do. The work that people do to earn money is called an occupation. So, why do we work? We work to earn money so that we can buy things with that money and earn our living. Okay, so occupation is the job what we are doing to earn money. Farming. Farming is the activity of growing crops and rearing animals on a farm. Okay, so farming is a type of occupation. Yeah, it is an activity of growing crops and rearing animals. Rearing means what? Taking care of animals in a farm. Our country has fertile lands which are good for growing crops. Now, what do you mean by fertile lands? Lands that are very good in their soil and very good for growing the crops. Farming is the main occupation of people who live in villages. Growing crops. So what do you mean by growing crops? Who grows the crops? The farmers sow seeds in the fields. The fields are then watered regularly. Many farmers depend on rainfall for watering their fields. Water is also taken from wells and tanks. Okay, here is a picture of well. Okay, if there is no rainfall, then the farmers depend on the well or the bore wells, and they fit the pumps to the bore wells and they water their fields. After sowing the seeds and watering the seeds, then what does the farmer do? After the crops are grown, they are harvested. Harvest means the activity of cutting and collecting the crops. The farmers sell the harvested crop in the market. Indian farmers grow what kind of crops? Rice, wheat, jute, sugarcane, pulses, fruits and vegetables, spices and more. What do you mean by spices? Spices means black pepper, okay, cardamom, clove, all these are called spices. Next. Okay. Rearing animals. Some domestic animals are kept on farms for rearing. Some of the animals such as cows and buffaloes are reared for milk. This activity is called dairy farming. Goats are reared for their meat. The sheep are reared for their wool. Can you see this picture, children? Yes. Here there is a picture of a farm where they are rearing the sheep. Okay, sheep are reared here so that they can get the wool from their fur and also they can get meat. So, can you see the sheep here? Yeah, this is a sheep farm and sheep are reared for their meat and their wool. Okay, then we have poultry farming. Yes, chicken and ducks are reared for their meat or eggs. This is called poultry farming. Next is fishing. Fishing is also a profession. Okay, it's an occupation. People living near the rivers or seas practice fishing. Fish is eaten as food in many places. It is also reared for oil and other products. Some places have big tanks in which fish are reared. This is known as fish farming. Next is forestry. Many parts of India are covered with forests. We get things such as wood, rubber, honey and gum from forest. People collect these things and are paid for their work. Wood is used to make many things such as furniture, paper and matchsticks. Rubber is used for making tires. Next occupation is mining. What is mining? Mining is digging the earth in search of minerals. Minerals are natural substances. Substances are nothing but things, okay? Minerals are natural substances that are found in rocks in the earth. India is rich in minerals such as coal, iron, petroleum, mica, and copper. Digging out these minerals from the earth is called mining. We get metals and fuels from minerals. Metals are used to make utensils. What are utensils? Utensils are things that we use for cooking, the cookwares. Okay, so even that is made with metals. Then machines, vehicles, bridges, and many other things. Many vehicles run on fuels. We get fuels such as petrol and diesel from petroleum. Buying and selling. Many things that we use are made in factories. These goods are transported to different shops and markets. The shopkeepers sell the goods to us. Some people give us services too. We take the services of doctors, postal workers, drivers, and telephone companies and others in our daily life. Yes, now you have learnt about occupation in this lesson. Every occupation has to be respected, whether it is big or small. We are coming to the end of this lesson now. So, complete exercise A, B, C in textbook and exercise D in your classwork. Refer page 12 and 13.